So let's now transition a little bit to some of the core strategies. You mentioned several mm-hmm. lifestyle ones. I'd like you to start with exercise.
Fantastic.
One of my favorite lifestyle strategies in general. So what's the impact of exercise? What kind of exercise should people do? How much should they do?
So as you know, exercise is phenomenal, mm-hmm. not just for osteoporosis and bone health, but there's so many other benefits to it. So what somebody should do depends on the person. This is individualized, mm-hmm. personalized medicine. Mm-hmm. And there are very simple things that people can do that are low impact. They don't even have to leave their home to do. Mm-hmm. One is called the stork exercise.
So can you demonstrate the stork exercise?
Oh, yes. I'd be happy to.
Okay.
So this is one that people can do just in their home while they're brushing their teeth. It's simple. You stand on one foot, mm-hmm. stand on one leg, and while you're brushing the bottom teeth, and dentists recommend a minute for the bottom teeth, a minute for the top, and then when you switch, you just switch legs. And if a patient needs to balance himself a little bit while they're brushing, they can do that, so they don't mm-hmm. fall. And what this does is it increases a little bit of core strength, a little bit of leg strength, but it increases proprioception and balance. And as we know, the number one risk for fracture is falling.
Right.
So anything that we can do, simple exercises all the way up to more complex yoga, things like that, anything we can do to increase proprioception and balance and decrease the risk for falling can decrease the risk for fractures.
Great.
So that's one that I love to talk to people about because it's entertaining to talk about
great.
It too.
It's great.
So they get engaged in the conversation.